He's still my wobbly table. Oh, hello all you malt meerschaum pipes. Ralphie here, Whiskey Review 97, following on from, 96, I know. And in 96, I was reviewing Glenfiddich 15-year-old Solera matured whiskey. And the reason was simple. I've had quite a number of emails over the last few months requesting a few whisky reviews, and I've taken the two most popular whiskies that were requested and stuck to my guns in this one, guys, because I have to be in a position where I would want to review it and would buy it myself. In other words, be prepared to pay the money for it, which is one reason why I haven't been reviewing the Ardbeg Supernova, because it's too expensive for a young whisky. But this isn't too expensive, and it gives you quite as big a pity moment as the Supernova. It is Ardbeg Laphroaig Quarter Cask. Right. Let's pour some. And I'll share this moment with you, wherever you may be. There we go. Pop the lid back on. Going to let this settle down. Ooh. And open up for a minute or two before I actually review the smell and the taste. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about quarter casks. If you ever see any old pictures of the smugglers in 18th, 19th century Scotland, with their horses making their way over the winding mountain passes, with their tartan shawls and bits and bonnets draped about them, all very romantic and not particularly true. The poor guys were dressed in rags, and they were struggling to make any sort of living for themselves. But that's another story for another review. But on the horses, there would be these small casks, liftable casks, hideable casks, and these are quarter casks. They have a capacity of approximately 40 litres to say 50, 55, even occasionally 60 litres, because cask capacity is never that regimented. You have the big hogsheads. They're not very transportable, quite rollable. Got to watch your fingers when you're rolling these barrels about. They're about 250 to 280 litres capacity. Then you've got the American barrels. They can be about 200 to 250 litres capacity. Then you have the quarter casks, about 40 litres. The octave, about 20 to 25 litres. Little blood casks, 10 to 15 litres. And that's what you occasionally see in shops, sitting up on the table as an ornament. And then you have your little domestic table casks, which hold about, 2-5 litres at the most. And people have them in their homes. They pour the whisky in the top, and it does a little bit of maturing, but shouldn't be left too long because it gets very woody. And then they open the little brass tap at the bottom, and the wee dram gurgles out. If you're interested, incidentally, in looking at these little tabletop casks, you'll find them at singlemaltsdirect.com. Moving on. Quarter casks were a recent experiment within the Scotch whisky industry to look at an alternative way of maturing whisky more quickly. Simple logic dictates that in smaller oak barrels, the surface of wood to spirit ratio is greater, therefore maturation of the whisky takes place quicker. Also, there is much more interaction of the breathing of the cask with smaller casks, so that they tend to mature that bit more speedily as well. So for example, you have a whisky here approximately 8 years old, roundabouts, but it's behaving more like a 12-year-old. One of the wonderful things about this is you retain that fresh, you retain that peaty freshness, freshy petness, no, peaty freshness. But you also get that rounded maturity of an older whisky. Which, if it was in a larger cask, you'd get that rounder, more matured nature, but the whiskey peatiness would be diminishing as the years go by, and you'll notice it how much of a difference there is between a 10-year-old peated whiskey and a 15-year-old peated whiskey. How the peat can really get knocked back quite a bit, and that happens a lot. It's a rare old cask that retains its peatiness into its 20s. So, what have we got on the nose of this Laphroaig quarter cask? A hell of a lot of peat, but very well natured. The freshness is there, that saltiness, that brininess has certainly helped, because this is a very craft orientated whiskey. It's bottled at 48%, so it's a bit stronger. It has not got caramel in it, although they don't say so on the label because of political reasons across the industry. And it has no chill filtration, and they mention that here. Non-chill filtered. Fantastic. Off to a good start here, guys. So, with this intact, authentic, well-presented whiskey, we have a real rich, syrupy, but floral-noted peat, minerally blast. There's a touch of white pepper, black pepper, rice wine. Remarkably, as it sits in the glass and calms down and starts to open up, for such a young whiskey, it's got an amazing maturity to it. I'm really very impressed with this. Taste-wise. Such an articulate, well-mannered, sweet, spicy arrival, which very rapidly evolves into that big, phenolic, iodine-loaded TCP peat blast, with smoke all around the edges, and pretty fresh smoke too. This is raw smoke. This is the smoke that chokes you when you're standing over a wooden fired barbecue. This really is. It's not hugely. We touch of water, not a lot, doesn't need it. It's not hugely sophisticated in its development, but that big arrival is complex, it's engaging, it's very articulate. Very, as I mentioned earlier, very well mannered. Water in it tones down the peat slightly. It brings out certain sharpness and citrus with the floral and that syrupy, that golden syrup sweetness. And it's wonderful the way it fades, rather like Highland Park, as it begins, as the peat starts to go back down your throat and disappear. It leaves behind this lovely, dry, crisp, mineral wee note, and a tiny wee touch of metallic about it, but very, very faint, very unobtrusive. Deliciously clean finish in this whiskey. Delightful stuff. I do recommend it if you love your peated whiskies. If you know someone who loves their peaty whiskies, they will thank you for this one. Maltmark, 90 out of 100. And I must commend Laphroaig for having the balls to present this whiskey, a higher strength, 48%, non-chill filtered, no caramel needed. How very refreshing. And the result of that policy is right there in the glass. Well, guys, that's Review 97. Hope you've enjoyed this. See you later.